Following the fatal crash of a paraglider, a short time after crossing a helicopter, the BA opened a safety investigation. The helicopter wake turbulence was studied. It was shown that the wake turbulence generated by the helicopter crossed the paraglider flight path, causing its wing to close and its fall to the ground. The investigation highlighted the lack of general information on wake turbulence among the Rotary Wing community, and as a consequence, the community's ignorance of the dangerous nature of the wake turbulence caused by helicopters which frequently fly close to other aircraft. Each aircraft disrupts the air mass to generate lift to fly. This disruption causes wake turbulence. For airplanes, separation rules exist, based on their size and weight, in order to protect the lightest from the wake turbulence of the heaviest. Helicopter pilots are aware of the disruptions they cause close to the ground. However, the risk their wake turbulence represents in flight is less known and is frequently underestimated. The H135, built by Airbus, is a four-blade twin-engine helicopter with a maximum takeoff weight of about 3 tons. The following phenomena presented in this video apply to all helicopters and are amplified with its mass. The difference in pressure between the upper and the lower sides of the blade creates the required lift for flight and pushes the air down in the rotor area. This is called downwash. At the blade tip, the difference in pressure also generates what is called tip vortices. The vortices of each blade interfere with the following blade, and as the helicopter flies forward, the vortices assemble to wakes. In hover, the effects of the downwash are globally located in a disk of around 3 times the rotor diameter. Pilots are familiar with the downwash, as it can be a risk at low height for the helicopter and people on ground. When the helicopter is in forward flight, the rotor plane works as an airplane wing. At the left and right borders of the downwash, a large pair of vortices forms, similar to airplane wake turbulence. Also, strong vortices generate additional small-scale turbulence within the whole wake system. The descending wake turbulence system is sustained for up to several minutes after being generated, which can mean hundreds of meters behind the helicopter. Just after its generation, the wake turbulence is strong and it reduces slowly by dissipation over time. As the wind shifts the wake turbulence away from its original position, the wake turbulence can affect both the air in the helicopter's flight path and in large areas around it. Several helicopter parameters influence the danger of the wake turbulence. In general, the greater the helicopter's mass, the greater the strength of its wake turbulence. Surprisingly, a helicopter generates a wake of higher strength with a slow forward speed. In slow flight or hover, the rotor power is applied to a smaller air volume, so velocity changes behind the helicopter's flight path are higher, increasing the danger of the wake. Let's now have a look at the accident investigated by the BA. For his mission, the pilot chose a landing area on a beach and took care to fly at a certain distance from the obstacles, which were kite surfers and a paraglider. There was a northwesterly wind of 15 knots. The blue scatter represents the wake turbulence behind the helicopter when it flew over the beach up to its landing area. The wake turbulence was transported by the northwesterly wind to the paraglider, finally crossing its path. He fell when the helicopter seemed to no longer represent a danger. The simulation showed that the induced air velocities close to the paraglider reached values superior to the maximum variation amplitudes the wing could stand, while having variable directions and amplitudes. This video was provided by a paraglider pilot. It shows that the effect of a helicopter wake turbulence can occur over relatively long distances, a while after being close to the helicopter. The paraglider was surprised by the collapse of his wing, as the helicopter was already at some distance. The pilot should ensure that he maintains a sufficient separation from the preceding aircraft in order not to be in danger of going through its wake turbulence. The few published studies show that the wake turbulence of a helicopter are greater than those of an airplane having an equivalent weight. In particular, wake turbulences of the largest helicopters are often similar to those of commercial airplanes. Also, due to the missions for which helicopters are used, they are more likely to be at a very close distance to other aircraft. As such, taking into account wake turbulence phenomenon is crucial for an efficient risk management for all stakeholders. Some national authorities have decided to consider the risk associated with this phenomenon in their communication.
Remember that the wake gets displaced by the wind. It will not only affect the air behind your helicopter, but it will also be spread over a large area. Helicopter pilots, your wake turbulence can stay longer and cover a greater area than you think. Its consequences can be fatal for other lighter aircraft close by and slightly below you. You must adapt your trajectory if your wake turbulence can possibly reach another aircraft. Light aircraft pilots, when you see a helicopter at a similar altitude coming towards you, adapt your trajectory and fly away as soon as possible to avoid the wake turbulence that can last several minutes. It is not because the helicopter flies away that you are out of danger. The increased distance to the helicopter is not a sufficient criterion to reduce the risk of its wake turbulence.